for Toronto Raptors starting in the other
on the road and hungry for a win against an Eastern Conference rival. The Milwaukee Bucks are ready for this thing to get started. And back in Toronto following the road trip, it's the Raptors on their home court. And of course, John Henson. Despite what he brought to this team in his absence, they've really taken off.
Well, his fans, his teammates, there are a lot of people that I'm sure are sad to see him go, given all he brings to the table. But I like what the trade does for him, and I bet it helps him right off the bat. I mean, it also is going to help him long term.
Well, you know, we'll see, because you don't make a change this drastic without having a period of adjustment. So you may be right. We'll see how long it takes and whether this new look roster can gel.
All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got, the dynamite pair of Antetokounmpo and Parker at forward. Creek is out there with Chris Middleton, and it's Monroe in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop.
Now here's Freak. Really played well against Portland in his last outing. He dishes it to Parker. Tries from 10. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. And just over a minute played here in the start of the game. And it's Lowry penetrating, and the shot is good.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on him.
For Milwaukee, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Parker against Patterson. Toronto grabs the miss. They defeated Indiana in their last game.
And guys, they could have won that game on the strength of their offense alone. It was that good.
And most impressive when you do it on the road like that. They just kept coming at them wave after wave, and they really kept the crowd on mute in that one.
Here's Freak. That one dropped for his second bucket. Mark him 2 for 4.
Match up.
The Raptors have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Now, here's Lowry. He's covered closely. Here's DeRozan. Can't get it to go. Now the Bucks take it the other way. Fresh from a win against Portland.
And you know what? Exactly what had to be done in terms of winning on the road. Never allowed any momentum to build up against them. Kept the crowd out of the game. And for every punch they took, they had a counter.
I was very impressed, Greg, with the way they stood their ground. Even when they were on their heels some, coming through those moments where they were backing up a bit. That's what it takes on the road. You've got to show that kind of fortitude and resilience.
Tries to keep it alive. Here's Valanciunas, and he banks in the layup. Valanciunas has got his first 2 points of the night.
Another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively so far.
Yeah, and I think we're going to see them operating a lot of their offense from the interior today.
Now here's Middleton. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. To the inside. And Freak gets it to go on the assist by Middleton. 6 points for Freak.
Outstanding entry pass there. He knew exactly where to go with the ball.
And it's Lowry penetrating. Here's Valanciunas. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spot. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be.
Antetokounmpo kicks to Monroe. Bucks passing it around. And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul. Shot misses. He'll be shooting 2. Milwaukee shooting their first free throws. First trip to the line in this one.
This season, in general, has not been kind to them at the free throw line. Only about 71%.
And, you know, you don't have to tell them what their free throw numbers are. I mean, they're well aware of it, believe me.
Here's what Toronto's going with right now. Biombo is checked in for Patterson. Ross comes in for Damari Carroll. Powell, he's checked in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Joseph in for Kyle Lowry. Now, here's Joseph. Coming in off a 10-point game, his last outing. 5 to shoot. The 19-foot shot. Bounces high off the rim and drops. 6 changes of the lead here.
Yeah, no team able to build a big lead early on. I mean, it's tight.
Yeah, both teams still kind of feeling their way through this game.
Carter Williams, rebound by the Raptors. Joseph with the ball. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. No good from Valanciunas.
Wow, I'm surprised. I thought that was definitely automatic.
And the Bucks miss again. The Raptors have gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. Now, here's Joseph, guarded closer. Out to the right wing. Powell down low. Carter Williams covering. Whistle blows. Yep, that's going to be a travel. Rivers, he's checked in for free. We've got 1:18 left in the first quarter. Toronto leading by 5. And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got. Filling out the wings, it's Middleton and Antetokounmpo. Monroe is out there with Jabari Parker. And it's Freak in at the point guard. He had a nice open look right there. Lowry's got 5 points so far.
That shot becomes effortless for him when the D is so relaxed. They've got to get more intense.
Here's the three. Milwaukee, no good that time either. Toronto's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Trailblazers, boy, was he tremendous. He had 37 points, and that scoring outburst set a new season high for him in what was a great exhibition on his part. Numbers like that make you anxious to see what he can do next time out.
All right, Doris, thanks so much for the report. You had to just marvel, guys, at what he was able to do that night, didn't you?
You know what? It was the game of basketball being played at its highest level. No question who their MVP was in that one.
No question whatsoever, Greg. I mean, that's a performance he and his fans will remember for a long, long time.
Now, here's Antetokounmpo following the miss by Kyle Lowry. Parker passes to Freak. Shot clock at 6. Three-pointer. Rebound by Kyle Lowry. Raptors leading by 6. And it's DeRozan at the elbow. That ball's nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. DeRozan's got 5.
Kyle Lowry with a beautiful setup.
Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin. They turn it over for the first time in the half. But you know what, partner? They've done a great job here in that regard. Really doing a nice job taking care of the ball and getting good shots.
Yeah, even though they trail, they're careful about the ball movement, and that is a good sign and will allow you a chance to build some momentum.
Now, here's DeRozan. They lead by 8. That's the biggest of the game. And now it's a double-digit lead. And that's now 7 points for Kyle Lowry. Parker outside. Jacks up a 3. And it's Freak missing. Toronto's gone 2 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the first. Carroll, no one around him. That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
And here's Lowry, following the three-pointer by Freak. Lowry dishes to Patterson. He kicks to Kira. Fires the 3. Milwaukee with the rebound. There's 49 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Monroe, left side. There's the feed to Freak. Screen by Monroe. Parker, a screen on Lowry. The Bucks need to get a shot off here. That is good. And it's 6 points for Jabari Parker.
You know, his ability is matched only by his energy, guys. I mean, he's usually in the middle of everything for his team.
Here's DeRozan. The shot's good on the assist by Lowry. Lowry's got assist number 5 here tonight.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense, Greg, has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. 4 straight field goals have been made off an assist.
Freak kicks to Monroe. The dish to Antetokounmpo, and another basket for Milwaukee.
You always hear about chemistry. That's a perfect example, knowing where each other is at all times.
And we've reached halftime in this one. Raptors lead by... Let's catch...
Thanks, Kev.
Glad to have you with us as more basketball is on the way. During the break, the players getting refueled with Gatorade. They're looking amped up and ready to get going once again. You look at Freak in this game, he has been everywhere.
Yeah, he's been a revelation tonight, almost scoring at will in that first half.
Really hard to fathom he'll be able to keep it up for the next two quarters, but you know, you never know. It could be a special night for him.
The star pair of Lowry and DeRozan are the guards. Patterson is the four with Valanciunas in the middle. And it's Carroll in at the small forward. They're the group for Dwayne Casey starting the second half. Lowry kicks to Valanciunas. The shot is off.
Move it, move it.
Bucks trail by nine. Parker outside. The shot by Middleton wide open. Nailed from three-point land.
For three.
Middleton's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Outside Lowry. Here's Valanciunas. Antetokounmpo pulls it in.
If they could end every possession with that shot, they'd be happy. Nine times out of ten, that's an easy layup for him.
Parker passes to Freak. Tipped away. 90 seconds now into the second half. Patterson a screen on Parker. Here's Carroll. Excellent D from Freak.
You know, he can be a little hesitant near the rim. We saw it there. If the defense offers just a little bit of resistance, he doesn't take it up quite strong enough.
Here's Parker. Here's Carroll. He's got five. And Patterson kicks to Carroll. Oh, and here we go. Antetokounmpo, nobody back. Flashes it down to finish the break.
That's how you make it happen, guys. Ball pressure and then a run out.
And that's how you flip the script in terms of momentum right there.
Feeds it to Valanciunas. DeRozan against Middleton. Valanciunas, and he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron.
My, he is so adept at finishing in the low post.
And a chance here to check out some stats on Chris Middleton. How his last 10 games have gone. He's been putting up about 4 points a game, two assists, and two rebounds. And the numbers won't wow you, but I like the effort he brings to the table each and every night.
Yeah, great hustle. Does all the little things. Just a good complimentary guy to have on your team. Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, yeah, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Hey, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
That is good. Powell's got 6 points.
What are they thinking, leaving him with all that space out there? Do they not know? Have they not heard? That this guy is unbelievable. That's a layup for him.
And that one's good. Freak.
Their three-point percentage has taken a big leap here in this second half.
And their lasers are starting to do their thing. I mean, that's going to be the ticket for him the rest of the way.
Kicks it to Powell. Here's Valanciunas. A stupendous finish in traffic. He's got eight.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Plumlee with the screen. Rivers dishes to Plumlee. Toronto grabs the miss. Valanciunas has got 4 rebounds in this game. Now, here's Joseph. He's guarded closely. Here's Powell. Rebound, Milwaukee. This, their first look at this year's Toronto squad.
Yeah, and these teams pretty familiar with one another. They'll face off four times this year.
And you know, Greg, both would love to get the upper hand early. This game to me is psychological as much as anything. I mean, a win here provides that edge you're looking for.
And even 3-on-3 break. And a wide open look for Freak. Nails the wide open jump shot. Freak's got 18 points.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Hi, Kevin. Jason Kidd was just going over the plan with his team.
Here's Freak. And Milwaukee looking at who they've got. The dynamite pair of Antetokounmpo and Parker at forward. Chris Middleton is out there with Freak. And it's Monroe in at the five, patrolling the paint.
I mean, you never expect to get opportunities that easy coming down the stretch of a tight game.
Lowry kicks to Biombo. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
And very little fight put up by the defense as he made his way to the bucket for the jam.
They did seem to take the cautious approach, Greg, when it came to defending that one. You're right.
And guys, it's not the time for caution now. I mean, they've got to be aggressive and take some risk to see if they can cut that lead down.
Raptors leading by five. Here's Powell. Screened by Valanciunas. They double him with Middleton. Lowry has the open look. Off target with his three.
One made three form for the game. Does he focus closer in? Let's see.
The kick out to Antetokounmpo. Pass to Freak for three. And a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. And that's 21 points for Freak. The drive by Lowry. Softly drops in the floater. And the Raptors lead by four.
You know, obviously, he knows how to finish with some flair.
Antetokounmpo passes to Freak. Here's Monroe. And there are the Bucks with another bucket.
Just no chance for the smaller defender to block that shot.
He's really, really good at using his size to free himself up for those mid-range jumpers. A master at it.
Lowry dishes to Valanciunas, and he makes it look easy, dunking it hard with one hand.
And guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't. Yeah, you're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
Well, it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt, but still, it only counts for two. Two is all.
A pretty free look from three-point range. The D forgot about him on that possession.
Lowry kicks to Powell. Count the bucket coming off a perfectly placed assist.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Here's Monroe. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, he'll shoot two.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
Old school D right there, just telling them no easy layups. It's as simple as that. And that's what you expect from them.
And the Raptors with some changes. Patterson comes in for Biombo. And Damari Carroll subbed in for Powell. Now here is Lowry. He's guarded closely. Valanciunas sets a screen for DeRozan. Screened by Valanciunas. Lowry passes to Patterson. That's in, coming off an assist from Lowry.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact that the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
Now here's Freak. Now recovering. Five to shoot. There's Freak. And they're unable to get the time basket there. Pass to DeRozan. Back to Lowry. No good from outside.
Even though he isn't having the best of games from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
Here's Middleton. Carroll with the rebound. Terrell's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Lowry with the ball. Now defended by Freak. Raptors moving the ball around. That's good. 11 points for Kyle Lowry.
And you're not going to pass up that kind of thing.
Freak dishes to Middleton. Parker kicks to Monroe. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for Toronto?
They keep piling up the assists, and they haven't cooled off at all.
Something we've also seen them doing tonight is getting the long ball to go down. Big points from outside.
Carroll kicks to Lowry. Antetokounmpo against DeRozan. Valanciunas passes to DeRozan. Lowry drives in. Lowry can't get that one to fall. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. 3-pointer. Nails it! And that shot brings them to within just 1.
What a bucket at one of the more crucial moments of the game.
How about the cool, collected way in which he delivered it? Clutch!
Had to foul, and on that occasion to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what, Greg? Who knows? A few misses at the strike, and they're right there within range. You know, late-game free throws are a lot different than early-game free throws in terms of making.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter to take the lead. Off target from downtown. And there's the intentional foul. No choice but to stop the clock here. First free throw is good, and that makes it a 3-point lead. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in.
They have a chance to tie it up.
A 3-ball would do just that.
Freak gets to Middleton. It's stolen by DeRozan. And so the big win by Toronto in a tight game. That was a fun night of basketball.